where Jesus Christ is glorified. Amen. We thank you, everyone who is here this evening. And those who is watching this broadcast this evening, we also welcome you and we thank you for being with us this evening. Amen. So we're gonna, let's we open up the service in prayer in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much. We thank you, Father, for who you are. We thank you, Father, for everything that you have done, continue to do in each of our lives. Lord, we thank you, Father, for this service this evening. And we ask you, Lord God, that you move in this service by your Spirit. Touch every person who is here tonight and every person who is watching this broadcast. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that we know that it's no distance in the Spirit, that you touch your people in the name of Jesus. Those who need a healing, Lord, that touch their bodies, Father, in the name of Jesus. And Father, we're giving you praise for everything what you're going to do tonight. And Father, as Pastor Larry come and ministering to us, we thank you, Lord God, that you use him as your instrument, as your vessel, that he will speak to your people with the clarity and simplicity, Lord. And Father, we thank you. Let your name continually be glorified forever and ever. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, this is the day that when we celebrate resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He is risen. He is alive. Amen. He is risen. He is alive. Hallelujah. So God is good and he is a faithful God. He is always will lead you. He is always direct you. And when you maybe kind of experience maybe tiredness in your body or maybe some aches and whatever, but he can renew the strength, because the scripture says he can renew your strength. So Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you renew the strength of your people. Father, the supernatural strength in the name of Jesus, there will be a strong in you. Amen. So, and you can say this, you can say, Father, I thank you that I'm going to be a strong in you. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthened me. It's nothing is impossible with God. You can do all things through him. Whatever God assigned you to do in your life, he will empower you to do. The power of God that is in you, the anointing of God is up in you to do what he called you to do. Amen? So don't say, well, I can't do this no more. Because you can do all things through Christ Jesus. Because this is what the enemy wants you to speak out of your mouth. Oh, I'm tired. Oh, I can't do that. No, you can do all things through Christ Jesus, because he can strengthen you. He can give you the supernatural energy, supernatural power and strength to move forward, to do and accomplish the things what you're supposed to do. Hallelujah. And sometimes it was, well, I was talking to one of the ladies today and we was kind of discuss how the tricks of the enemies. Sometimes, you know, people say, well, tomorrow I have to go to work and I'm, you know, I need my schedule. I'm going to be tired, so I don't want to come to church. And but the thing is, when you was in a world and you party to 2, 3 o'clock in the morning and then go to work with a hangover, that was okay. And this is a time when you're serving the Satan. But now you're a child of God. You are washed by the blood of Jesus. This dedication to the service of the Lord. Lord, I'm going to be serving you. I will be committed to the assignment, to the work that you call me to do. I know that you will empower me, that you will strengthen me, and I will be committed to that work, because maybe your work is to be a part of the ministry and to be ushering, right? And you might be just be a service for the children. And God gonna empower you, and he will reward you. Hallelujah. Because God is a faithful God, and his character is a faithfulness. And so we want to be continually transforming his image and his likeness and walk in the faithfulness. So we are faithful to the work what he called us to do. Amen. And so if you work with children, you are faithful to that work. And God will strengthen you, and he will reward you for that. Hallelujah. Amen. Continually walk by faith and not by sight. So Pastor Larry, he's going to be ministering to us tonight. And so we're just going to expect to hear from heaven, because when the minister speaks, we believe that we're not just to listen to the minister. We believe that we hear what the Spirit of God saying to us through that minister. Amen. Hallelujah. So before he come and start ministering to us, we also wanted to lift up you and your families, because we love you dearly. We always pray for our partners, our supporters, and all of you. And we love you and continually pray for you and for your family. And we believe that this ministry and this church, we are a house of prayer. So prayer is the important part of this ministry, and is an important part in our lives. And we want that this will be an important part in your life, because God is answering prayers in Jesus' name. So, Heavenly Father, I lift unto you, Lord God, your people. And I lift unto you, Lord God, their families, their children, their loved ones, and everyone who they pray for, their neighbors. And Father, we ask you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you touch your people, touch their families, Lord. Those who do not know you, we pray, Father, for their salvation. We thank you, Father, that you take the blinds off of their family's life and off of their children's spiritual eyes. And Father, we call their family members to the kingdom. We thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, Father, for every obstacle, every situation or circumstances that your people going through, those who we pray right now. Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you are God and bigger of any circumstances and any situation, that you're God here who can change around that circumstances. And Father, we apply the blood of Jesus over your people, the blood of Jesus over their families, the blood of Jesus over their children, grandchildren, loved ones, and those who they pray. And Father, we take authority in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, and we cancel every work of the Satan over their lives in the name of Jesus. And Father, we release your plan, we release your will over their life in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you that your name will be glorified for their families. We call it in restoration in their families and their relationships. And Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. We just thank him. We thank you, Lord. Thank the Lord. In advance. Thank you. I thank you, Father, for the restoration. Thank you, Father. Restore, Lord. Restore, Lord, finances. Father, we thank you, Lord God, that you will meet the people's needs, that they have more than enough. We thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, Pastor Larry is here, so get ready to receive the word of God, and in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. I believe I will sing a song. I was at this conference and I heard this brother singing a song that was that really touched my heart. And the title of the song was "Wash the Lamb." And I feel like I want to sing that song today. Amen. If y'all don't mind, it blessed my heart when I heard him sing, because I hadn't heard it in a long time. And I hope I can do it. Amen. Yeah.
Oh, Shakanda. Let me pray.
Glory to God. Glory. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for this evening. We thank you, Lord God, for your presence. Holy Spirit, you're welcome in this place. We invite you in right now to take your place. And Father, I thank you for what you want to do in the hearts and in the minds of your people today, Lord God. I thank you, Father, that you're going to speak to our hearts. You're going to cause us to believe. And as we believe, fathers, we will see the manifestation of your word come to be a living reality in our lives. Thank you for that, Father. Now, Lord, I ask you that you would touch every heart and every soul under the sound of my voice. Take this vessel of clay. Let there be none of me but all of you. And let your word go forth tonight under the anointing of your Holy Spirit. I give you praise and glory for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to sing a song. Now, I don't have the copyright for this song, but when I bought the song, it was for the purpose to sing it, and that's what I'm going to do. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Give me all you want to take now. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Walking on the road to Jerusalem today, the time has come to sacrifice again. My two small sons, they walk beside me on the road. Reason that they came to watch the Lamb. Daddy, Daddy, what will we see then? There's so much that we don't understand. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. There will be so many in Jerusalem today. We must make sure the Lamb doesn't run away. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. When we reached the city, I knew something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers, no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. Then I heard the crowd cry out, "Crucify him!" We tried to leave the city, but we could not get away. Forced to play in this drama, a part I did not wish to play. Why upon this day were men condemned to die? And why were we standing where soon they would pass by? I looked and I said, even now they come. The first one cried for mercy. The people gave him none. The second one was arrogant. He was arrogant and loud. I still could hear his angry voice screaming at the crowd. Then someone says, "There's Jesus." I can't believe my eyes. The man was so badly beaten, he barely looked alive. Blood flowed from his body, from the thorns upon his brow, running down the cross and falling to the ground. I watched him as he struggled. I watched him as he fell. The cross came down upon his back. The crowd began to yell. In that moment, I felt such agony. In that moment, I felt such loss. Till the Roman soldier grabbed my arm and screamed, "You carry his cross." At first I tried to resist him. Then his hand reached for his sword. And so I knelt and took the cross from the Lord. I placed it on my shoulder and started down the street. The blood that he's been shedding is now running down my cheek. They led us to Golgotha. They drove nails deep in his feet and hands. Yet upon the cross, I heard him pray, "Father, forgive them." Oh, I never have I seen such love in any other eyes. Into thy hand I commit my spirit. He prayed, then he died. I stood for what seemed like years. I've lost all sense of time, till I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the oldest say, "Father, please forgive us, the lamb ran away." Daddy, Daddy, what have we seen here? There's so much that we don't
understand. So I took them in my arms and we turned to face the cross. Then I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. Jesus, watch the Lamb.
Song, but that impressed me last night, so I just wanted to sing that song, amen, and I pray that it ministered to your heart as well as it did to mine, because I enjoyed it. I truly enjoyed it, amen. Now, tonight we're talking about believing. You must believe with the heart. You must believe with the heart. Amen. Let's look at Mark chapter 11. Mark chapter 11. And we'll just start there. And we're going to believe that we're going to be able to bring this subject out to a point where you can understand, believe with your heart, and receive what God is saying. In Mark chapter 11, I want to look at verse number 22. And Jesus answered and said unto them, he's talking to his disciples, he said, have faith in God. Have faith in God. Verse 23, for verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Verse number 24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when you pray, believe. Where you're going to believe at? With the heart. Believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. And if the same thing apply to receiving healing from the Lord. Amen. God wants us to learn the value of believing with the heart. The Bible says in Romans chapter 10, verse number 17, said, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. I'm going to say that again. Romans 10, 17. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. Amen. Romans 10, 17, that ain't what it says though, huh? Romans 10, 17 says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now, in Romans chapter 10, and verse number 10, Romans chapter 10, verse number 10 said, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness. And I like this right here, because what I believe with my heart, I need to learn to confess it with my mouth. Confess what? That which I believe in my heart. Amen. So he said, verse number 10, Romans chapter 10, verse 10, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Amen. So what is the confession? That what am I confessing? I'm confessing that, Lord, you bore my sicknesses, you carried my diseases, and by your stripes, I am healed. Amen. So as I believe the word of God,
And as I confess what God has said in his word, God is not going to leave his word undone. God will confirm his word with signs following. Everything we need from God has been made available. I want you to know that, I want you to notice that God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. Amen. God is speaking to our hearts today like never before. Amen. And now in John chapter 14, let's look at something here. John chapter 14, let's look at verse number 16. John chapter 14, verse number 16, he said, "And I will pray the Father, and he shall what? Give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever. Even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him. But ye know him, for he dwelleth with you, and shall be in you." Well, where is he in you? He's in your heart. He's in your heart. Amen. He's in your heart. Amen. And so, and as we come to understand it, as we begin to see what he's doing here, look at verse number 19. "Yet a little while, and the world seeth me no more. But ye see me, because I live, ye shall live also." Amen. So we see that God, he's not dead. Oh my God, he's not dead, folks. He's alive. He's alive. Amen. Glory to God. He is alive. So what? So God wants to believe, learn the value of believing with the heart. Amen. To learn the value of believing with the heart. Now, why is that so important? Because, see, God is a faith God. God operates in the realm of the spirit, and he wants us to connect with him in the spirit. Amen. In the spirit. Why? Because that's where he resides, in the spirit, not in the flesh, but in the spirit. In the spirit. Glory to God. And as we come to him in the spirit, we experience his goodness and his mercy. Amen. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse number 18. He said, Let no man deceive himself. If any man among you seem to be wise in this world, let him become a fool, that he may be wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. For it is written, he taketh the wise in their own craftiness. Amen. See, so many times we think that we are ahead of the game, when all the time we bring ourselves into a snare. Why? Because we try to work things out from a natural standpoint. Amen. From the natural man. I want to take you somewhere else. Look at 2 Corinthians. Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 10. In 2 Corinthians chapter 10, now I want you to see this, because you see, a lot of times we are struggling because we entertain different thoughts, and because we entertain these different thoughts, they filter into our heart because we have meditated upon them. And you know what you think on the most, that what you're going to eventually start acting on? Amen. What you think on is what you're eventually going to start acting on. And so look what he says right here, because you see, we got to learn to exercise authority even over our thoughts. Amen. Because as a man thinking in his heart, the Bible says, so is he. Now in here in 2 Corinthians chapter 10, and look at verse number 3, he says, "For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh." Amen. "Though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh." Verse 4, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds." Where's the battleground that we have to contend with in this spiritual conflict that we're experiencing daily? Where's the battleground? It's our mind. Satan attacks our mind. And he tried to get you to revert back to your old life, to the things that you formerly, the way you formerly lived before Christ. And because he tried to overthrow the mission that you have been given. And if he can overthrow it in your mind, he can overthrow it in your heart. If he can overthrow it in your mind, he can overthrow it in your heart. Because you see, we have to learn to believe what God has said concerning us. Because the Bible said in John chapter 14, verse number 10, he said, verse number 10, he said, believe thou not that I am in the Father, and the Father in me. Amen. See, if the Father's in you, and you are in the Father, what God has made available to you is connected to the spirit realm, amen, and is connected to your thought pattern. That's why it's so important that we understand how to believe God for the promise of God to be released in our lives. We must learn the power of believing with the heart. Amen. Believing with the heart. Why? Because what you believe in your heart, you're going to speak. You're going to talk about it. You're going to confess it. Amen. Just like when you go to the doctor and he might even misdiagnose you. And he tell you that you got some dreadful disease. And he might have misdiagnosed you. But because you start talking about it, you go share it with your friend, you go share it with your neighbor, then all of a sudden, you begin to experience those symptoms all just because the doctor found something in your blood, and now you're starting to talk about it. What did you just do? See, your words are full of life. Your words, especially if you're a child of God, because God has given you the power to speak and to declare and to decree. And what you begin to speak out of your mouth, what you begin to speak out of your heart and out of your mouth, you're going to see the manifestation of it. That's why it's so important that we understand how to believe properly. If we learn to believe properly, then we need to learn to speak properly. Why? Because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Now notice this now. And notice this in verse number four, once again, this is 2 Corinthians chapter 5, chapter 10, I mean, 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse number 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God, listen at this now, to the pulling down of strongholds. Where is the strongholds established? In our mind. Amen. He attacks our mind and he gets us believing stuff that we should not believe it. We should not be believing. He gives us the thinking on things we should not be thinking on. And the next thing you know, the enemy has established a stronghold. Now we have to deal with this in a very powerful way. What do you mean, Pastor? Now I'm not just dealing with my thoughts. I'm dealing with the enemy that has placed the thoughts in my mind. Because now I'm having to go into spiritual. I'm having to go into a warfare, I had to go into spiritual warfare. Why? Because I got to learn to cast down. Because now the spirit of depression coming upon me. Why? Because I have allowed the enemy access. Now I got to learn to cast down these thoughts instead of entertaining these thoughts. I need to cast down these thoughts. Why? Because if I don't cast them down, I'm going to be brought into a snare. I'm going to be brought into captivity to the enemy of my soul. Amen. So notice what he said, verse number five. He said, casting down imagination in every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God. Well, that's why we need to understand what God's will is in our life, especially when it comes to our health. We need to understand the will of God concerning our health, because see, the Bible tells me in Isaiah chapter 53, verse number 4, says, surely he had borne our grief and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him, stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. Amen. Verse number 5 says, and he was wounded for our transgressions, he was bruised for our iniquities, the chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes, the Bible says, that we are healed. We are healed. If the Bible said that we are healed, now what is there to hinder us from believing that? Again, the enemy began to go throw those fiery dots at your mind. That's why the Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 6 and verse number 10, he said, finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. And he commands us to do what? Put on the whole armor of God. that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand, stand. Amen. Why you need to put on the whole armor of God? Because that devil, he's not going to give up just because you overthrow him the first go-round. He's going to come after you again. And that what he did for Jesus? When he come out of the wilderness, when Jesus come out of the wilderness, he didn't attack Jesus only one time. He attacked Jesus three times. First of all, he attacked him with his identity. If thou be the Son of God, command these stones to be made bread. See, what was he doing? He was attacking his thought pattern. He was attacking his thought pattern. Amen. And that's the same thing he do to us. Amen. Because see, the devil know more about you than you know about yourself. He know everything that you went through before you accepted Christ. Why? Because he don't want to put all this in your path. He put all this in your pathway so that he can trap you up. Amen. But get this. God has given you the power over all the powers of the enemy. Amen. And he said that nothing shall by enemies hurt you. Look at Luke chapter 10, verse number 19. Behold, I give unto you power to tread over serpents and over scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt you. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. So we have to understand what God is saying to us. Because, you see, if I'm going to have faith, if I'm going to release, if I'm going to believe what God has said concerning me, then I got to believe that God is not a man that he should lie. That he, nor a son of man, he should repent. And that what he has said, he's also able to bring it to pass. Amen. He's able to bring it to pass. Glory to God. Amen. And so y'all understand what we're saying now, right? Amen. Now let's look at something else here. Let's look at something else here because we're starting to get a hold of this now. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Now look at 1 Corinthians chapter. Oh my God. That's not it. Oh my God. How did that happen? I mean, thank you, Lord. I'm looking at 2 Corinthians. That's what's wrong. Let's go to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. 1 Corinthians chapter 6. Thank you, Lord. We're here now. That's looking better. Now look at verse number 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Look at verse number 18 through 20. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18 through 20. Is that flee fornication. Every sin that a man do it is without the body. But he that committed fornication sinned against his own body. Verse number 19 is one that we want to look at. Amen. What? Know ye not that your what? Body is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God. Ye are not your own. Verse number 20. For ye are bought with a price. See, the devil knows that you have made a commitment to God. Amen. To believe God. And that's why God tells us in the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse number 23, so for verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart. You see, because doubt is the same area where faith takes place, and if the enemy can get you to doubt God, that means that you won't have faith to believe God. Why? Because they both are produced in the same place, and there's only one can work at any given moment. Amen. So when I look at this, when I see what God is saying here, look at verse number 20 again. Is it 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse number 20. For ye are bought with a price. Henceforth glorify God in your body and in your spirit. And in your spirit. Why? Because your spirit, you are a spirit. The real you is the spirit. Amen. You have a soul, you live in a body. Glory to God. Amen. So we're gonna come to God as He created us. We're gonna come before Him. We're gonna acknowledge Him as He is, so are we in this earth. as he is, so are we. See, what do you mean, Pastor? God is a spirit. Amen. And that, am I right? Then he tells us in John chapter 4, and I think verse number 22. Let me just turn that real quick, because it John chapter 4. Amen. Verse number 22. Ye know not what ye worship, for we know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. Amen. Glory to God. Verse number 24. God is a spirit, and they that worship him, get this now, must worship him in spirit and in truth. See, we have to understand that we are spirit beings created in the image of God. We have the ability to think like God. We have the ability to operate in the same as Jesus operated in the earth. Why? Because he abides in us and we abide in him. Amen. What do you mean, Pastor? Well, look at John chapter 11. John chapter 14, I mean. Look at verse number 10. John chapter 14, verse number 10. Now notice what he said. Believest thou not that I'm in the Father, and the Father in me? The words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Amen. So if God is doing something in me and through me, let me tell you something. It's not something that I'm doing. It's him doing it through me. My job is just to simply believe the word. Believe in my heart that what God has said, he's able to bring it to pass. Amen. So now look at verse number 11 said, believe me that I'm in the Father and the Father in me, or else believe me for the very work's sake. Amen. So that showed me that I'm not the one that's actually doing the work. I'm just the middleman. God is the one that's actually doing the work. Amen. God is the one that's actually doing the work. What am I doing? I'm just a vessel I'm just a yielded vessel. I'm a yielded vessel. So he have hands to work with. He have feet to walk on. He have a mouth to talk through. Amen. How are you going to do that? By his spirit. If I yield to him, that means he's controlling this body. Why? Because I believe in my heart that what God has given me to do, that he's also able to bring to pass. But at the same time, I must be a yielded vessel. I must yield to God. Because he said, for with the heart men believe it. For with the heart man believe it. Romans 10:10, for with the heart man believe it. Amen. With the heart man believe it. If I believe what God has said, if I yield to what God has said, now I become an instrument in the hand of God. I become an instrument in the hand of God. Hallelujah. Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Yes,
amen. Amen. Because see, we have to see what God is saying to us, because you see, we are in this world, we're not of this world. We are in this world. We are not of this world. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Now, in the book of Romans, my God. Look like I scribbled over my note, but I can't honestly. Let me just see. Okay, so now we'll just look at something else, because I don't want to mess this up, because we have a place in this world that God is the center core of our being, and that's when we believe God. God is able to make all grace abound toward us. We have an all sufficiency in all things. And may abound to every good work. Amen. That's why it's so important. Look at 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 4. 1 Peter 2:4. Glory to God. 1 Peter. There we go. 1 Peter 2. There we go. Thank you, Lord. 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 To whom coming as unto a lively stone, disallowed indeed of men, but chosen of God. Chosen of God and precious. See, God sees you as so precious. He sees you as so precious. Amen. He sees you as so precious. Then in Psalm, and then in Psalms 23, verse 7. In Psalms 23, verse number 7. Don't y'all go nowhere now.
Y'all stay with me. Y'all stay with me. Psalms 23 and verse number 7. And it reads, Psalm 23, verse number 7. It says, Psalms 23, verse number. Psalm 23, verse number, look at verse number 3. He restored my soul. He lead me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Look at verse number 4. Yea, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou with me, Lord, your word and your spirit, they comfort me. Thou prepared a table before me in the presence of mine enemy. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Verse number 6. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. If I believe in God, then I must understand that I'm not alone. That he's with me. That his rod and his staff, they comfort me. That he prepared a table before me. Amen. In the presence of my enemy. Amen. He prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy. So what it means to believe in the heart? Let's go back now to the book of Mark. The book of Mark. Glory to God. And I'm getting ready to close this thing now. In the book of Mark. In the book of Mark. There we go. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the book of Mark, chapter 11, once again. Now notice what he says here. Verse number 23 again. For verily I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain. See, as I begin to believe the word of God, as I begin to stand on the promise of the word of God, I can speak the word of God in faith, and God answers by faith. God answers by faith. Notice what he says here. Now, look at verse, look here. And shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he said. If I can believe it, if I can believe it, if I can believe it, the sickness that is plaguing my body, if I can believe it, the Bible says in Psalm 107, verse 20, that he sent his word and he healed them and delivered them from their distress. If I can believe it, glory to God. Yeah. You see, I'm only going to obtain from God that which I can believe. If I can't believe it, I'm not going to get it. But if I can believe it, then the promises that God made are mine. They are mine. Glory to God. If I can believe it, glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Now, notice here, verse number 24. Therefore, I say unto you, what things of ye desire when you pray? What things of ye desire when you pray? See, what is that word desire? That word desire is just like, what things of you are hoping for when you pray? What things of you believing for when you pray? And that brings me back to Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 1. That brings me back to Hebrews 11, 1. Amen. And what is that? Now, faith is the substance of things what? Hoped for. And the evidence of things not seen. So now, if my hope is in proper alignment with what God is saying, amen. So now I'm coming in agreement to the will of God. And as I come into agreement with the will of God, now I'm in a position now to receive the promise of God. I'm in a position now to receive the promise of God. Why? Because I have set myself in the position where faith can be produced. How did I do that? As I begin to, is that faith in certain things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. See, that hope birthed a desire in my heart to take that step to believe God. Amen. To take a step to believe God. Notice this, what he said right here in Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 5. He said, by faith Enoch was translated that he should not see death and was not found because God had translated him
For before his translation, he had this testimony, to get this, that he pleased God.
Amen.
That he pleased God. And look at verse number 6. He said, but without faith, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that come to God must believe that he is. See, believing with the heart. Believing with the heart. That's how important it is, folks. We must believe with the heart. You know, there was a lady called me to come pray for her. And as I was on my way to go to pray for her, my car ran hot. And had never run hot before. And so I had to stop and take care of that situation. Then I got back on the road and headed on in that direction. It ran hot again. It was no reason for it to be running hot. But I believe that God wanted to do something. I believe that God had me on a mission, and the devil tried to stop me. See, if I'd yield to the things that was coming against me and not believe that and not believe what God would put in my heart to do, I would have been defeated. That woman probably would have died at that time. But because I was persistent, and pressed on in, I took care of that radiator again. Now, and I drove on to the house. I made it to the house, they began to talk to me. The mother began to talk to me, and as she began to talk to me, I said, I'm not going to pray for you right now. Let me just minister to you first. Then I'll pray for you. And as I began to minister to her, I established her faith. I built up her faith so that she can believe. She had a hole in her heart. The doctor said it's getting larger and enlarging itself. Amen. But when I arrived to the house, I ministered to her. And the hole began to close up in her heart. Amen. As I began to pray with her. And she went back to the doctor. Amen. And the hole was about to pretty much closed up. Why? Because I was persistent in obeying God. I was persistent in obeying God. Amen. See, why? Because I believed in my heart that God had sent me on this mission. And then let me tell you something. After I done took care of this, my car never ran hot no more. It was the enemy trying to stop me from carrying out the will of God. See, if I had paid more attention to what my vehicle was going through, I would never have accomplished that what God was sending me to do. You understand what I'm saying? When God gives you a mission, when God puts something on your heart to accomplish, there's opposition that you're going to have to deal with first. Majority of the time, he's not going to give you something, and the enemy just going to let you do it without any opposition. And I'm telling you that because your faith plays a great part in you accomplishing the plan of God for your life. Your faith has a great part to do with it. Amen? Because you got to press in. Remember, we wrest not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Amen. Against spiritual wickedness in high places. Amen. And those fire darts are going to come at you so strong, so hard, and it's going to be up to you to stand your ground. It's going to be up to you to stand your ground. Hallelujah. For those of you that believe for healing right now, believe with your heart what God has said concerning your health and your healing. Because it's already yours. God has already provided your healing for you. If thou canst believe, the Bible said, Mark 9:23, all things are possible to him that believe. Amen. Because if you believe it, then you're not doubting. Doubt is the destroyer of your faith. So let's believe God right now. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, I thank you that your word would not return void. I thank you, Father, that you will accomplish that what pleases your heart. And as we have brought this message forth, Lord God, I believe, Father, that someone's faith has come to another level, and they are ready to believe the truth of your word. They are ready to believe the truth of your word. Your word is life and health and healing to all our flesh. Amen. Your word is life, health, and healing to all our flesh. Amen. In Proverbs chapter 4, look at verse number 20, and it says, my son, attend to my words, incline thy ear to my saying. Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. For they are life to those that find them and help to all their flesh. Keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. That's why it's so important that we believe what God said, because out of your heart flows the issues of life. As a man believe, that's what he's going to produce in his life, that which he believed. Amen. Glory to God. Father, I thank you that your principles will produce the results that we are believing for. And as we apply to our lives, we'll not have to wonder, will it work? We know your word will work, because we know that you will confirm your word with signs following, according to Mark chapter 16, verse 20. You confirm your word with signs following. And so, Father, we thank you and we bless you. Now, Father, I pray for all those that are believing for healing in their body. I take authority over that spirit of infirmity. I bind it up in the spiritual realm right now in the name of Jesus. I bind up every spirit of infirmity, sickness, and disease. I bind it and I loose it from its assignment. Father, I release your divine touch right now in the name of Jesus. I release it by faith upon their bodies, Father. Touch right now in Jesus' name. And I give you all the praise and all the glory for what you're doing in the hearts of your people. And may your name be forever glorified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. I pray that I said something that will spark your, get your faith to be active. You have an active faith. God wants you to have an active faith, not a passive faith. He wants you to have an active faith. Amen. And I pray that God calls your faith to become active. Amen. We're going to go ahead and take our evening offering up. Those of you that want to sow a seed, you go to my website, libraryministries.com. Amen. You can sow your seed, or you can go to, you can use your Cash App, your Vimeo app. Amen. Or you can send it through the postal service. That's P.O. Box 41-7913, Sacramento, California, 95841. Amen. Glory to God. Father, I thank you for those that are sowing their seed right now, Father. And I ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that as we sow our seed, let us keep our hearts in the right place so our seed will produce after its kind. It'll come back into our lives, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall be given to our bosom. And don't forget, we're preparing to go back to Pakistan. And if you want to sow a significant seed to help us out, we ask you to do that also. We have already established a mission account. So everything that comes for the mission will go directly into the mission account. And we're asking you to have a little compassion and help us out. Amen. Father, I pray for those that are you're dealing with their hearts to sow that specific seed, Father, for the mission, for souls. God, I ask that you would, Lord, let this not be something that they will miss, but Lord, let it be something, Father, that they will release in faith so that they can receive the benefit of their doing. And God, I thank you for it in Jesus' name. I bless your people. And I thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that your word will not return void. Now listen, you stop acting the food back there. I'm not going to tell you. Thank you, Lord. Amen. So go ahead on, so you see.
Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Shalababokurabasi. Thank you, Lord. Now, for those that never asked Jesus Christ to come in their heart, I want to talk to you now. Those of you that have asked Jesus to come in your heart, but you backslid, you walked away from God, and now you want to rededicate your life to the Lord, I'm talking to you as well. You never gave your heart to the Lord, but now you want to. Or you have given your heart to the Lord, but you backslid. You turned away and began to venture away to the old lifestyle because the enemy come against your mind and make you to make you believe that you could not walk this walk. I'm going to tell you right now that God is not mad at you. He loves you still, and he wants you to return to him. Amen. He's married to the backslider. He loves you still. Say this with me. You that want to ask Jesus Christ to come in your heart for the first time, you that want to repent and rededicate your life to the Lord, say this prayer with me right now. Say, Lord Jesus, I repent of my sin. Forgive me, Lord. I made a mistake. Come into my heart. Create in me a right spirit and renew in me a clean heart. Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God and that you died for my sin. Because I believe this and confess with my mouth, I'm saved. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you said that simple prayer, right now I believe that God is smiling at you. The angels are rejoicing because of you. Amen. Now, if you need a place to serve God, a place to learn to worship God, ask God, God, what would you have me to go? What shepherd would you have me to set under that I may learn who I am as a new believer? Amen. God will direct you, because not every pastor can be your pastor. You may need something special, and God has a special person equipped with that is able to meet your needs spiritually. Amen. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for what you're doing in their lives. I ask you, Father, that you would visit them, that you would touch their lives, their hearts, God, and bring them to a place, Father, where they would totally, totally turn away from their path. You said, if any man be in Christ, you said, he's a new creature. You said, old things are passed away, and behold, all things become new. Father, let it be even as you have spoken it, in Jesus' name. And I thank you for it, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Anyone need special prayer today? No? Then let's just pray for those with us by the internet. Father, we thank you for those that are with us by the internet, those that are watching us on television, those that are listening on radio, Lord God. Father, we pray for them. We lift them up before you, Father. And we declare and decree in the name of Jesus Christ that supernatural peace will rest upon their hearts and their mind. Peace that surpasses all understanding shall keep their hearts and their mind in Christ Jesus. That they will begin to think on the things which are good, those things which are pure, those things which are lovely, those things which are just, those things which are of a good report. Father, you said, should there be any praise, should there be any virtue, we shall think on these things. So, Father, I release that now upon them so that they can believe and receive the promise in Jesus' name. We love you. God bless you. This is Pastor Larry. See you again on Tuesday afternoon, Tuesday night. God bless you. Bye-bye.